The future of .NET has just been completely revealed at .NET Conf 2024. I'm going to summarize the entire keynote in 20 seconds and then tell you what it means for you and your future as a .NET dev. Roll the summary.
.NET Aspire.
.NET Aspire. Talk more about Aspire.
.NET Aspire is
an Aspire-ified code base. You could use Aspire and
I was launching my Aspire app. Aspire enables you to see what's happening straight in my Aspire dashboard. The Aspire templates, Aspire's service discovery system, Aspire, owned by us on the Aspire team, the .NET Aspire community toolkit.
I'm so excited.
Aspire 9, .NET Aspire, .NET Aspire.
.NET Aspire, .NET Aspire, .NET Aspire, .NET Aspire.
.NET Aspire 9 just shipped.
Yes, the entire thing was about .NET Aspire, and I was sad enough to count how many times they said the word Aspire. They said it 56 times in the space of about an hour. That's almost one time a minute. Straight after the keynote, the team went to do a Reddit AMA, Ask Me Anything, to talk about .NET Aspire, and I snuck on the call, and this is what they said.
Remember when that person said on Twitter, I put that shit on everything?
Yes.
Aspire.
So yes, they swear like champions in the office, which I think is pretty cool. I was also sad enough to go back and count how many times they actually did, they mentioned Aspire in 2023, and the number's gone up, right? So Aspire is even more important. And if you thought that was sad, watch this. Over the last 4 years, these are the mentions of various .NET technologies, okay? And I think this is extremely important. MAUI. MAUI had a good start in 2021. It was mentioned quite a bit. Dipped in 2022. And then has been steady over 2023, 2024. Copilot, interestingly, is now almost more mentioned than MAUI. I think this is quite ironic, considering that GitHub Copilot is supposed to put .NET developers out of their jobs, but fine. Blazor. Now, Blazor's had... we'll talk about Blazor in a minute, but Blazor has had a bit of a roller coaster. It was really popular in 2021, barely mentioned at all in 2022, had a bit of a comeback in 2023, but now it's basically not mentioned. And oh well. That's all I can say to that. C#, though, again, follows kind of the trail of Blazor there, and it's barely mentioned this year. Don't mind that, because C# shouldn't be the focus, and there shouldn't be new stuff about C# every single year, which if you've been watching this channel, you'll know that is my opinion. And last, containers. Containers had a huge push. Obviously, it was a big focus in 2022, and Aspire has kind of taken over that, I guess. So I've done this in chart form. So you can have a little... Oh, it's gone dark. Let me turn the lights on a bit. There you go. I was being lit by my PowerPoint there. Okay. So, yeah, you can see here containers got a peak. But now, on the far right in 2024, it is Aspire. MAUI's still doing okay, but it's Aspire and Copilot. And this is for a classic .NET dev, the fact that we're now focusing so much on infrastructure concerns instead of software development concerns is a little bit of a bother to me personally. Let's go back to Blazor then, and Blazor's quite an important story and kind of the moral of this video. Blazor was mentioned six times in the keynote. So Blazor was made and invented by a British guy whose surname ends with Anderson, obviously, so I should love him, Steve Sanderson. Great taste in haircuts as well. What did they have him doing at .NET Conf 2024 keynote? The inventor of Blazor. Let's take a look.
So now I'm going to use OpenAI with a different connection string. That's also going to be supplied by Aspire. So it's still all orchestrated by Aspire.
Yes, the inventor of Blazor was shilling Copilot and OpenAI service and Aspire. It wasn't shilling Blazor. So is Blazor over? Well, did it ever begin, is the question. Now, you all know Nick Chapsis, yeah? He's really cool and is the most popular .NET YouTube channel on the entire platform website. And 3 years ago, he made a Blazor video called Why I'm Worried About Blazor and Its Future. Well, he had to delete it. He was Microsoft MVP, and he said, hello, everybody. Wasn't happy with the Blazor video, so I deleted it. I watched the video 3 years ago. It was one of the reasons I started my channel. I wanted to be honest and authentic about my genuine opinions. So Nick, if you are watching this, I agree. I agreed at the time, and your video was correct. So obviously the big question then is, should you actually use Aspire? Should you use it? Okay, should you use it? And believe it or not, for a cynical guy like me, the answer is yes. And this is why, yeah? This is why. Microsoft use it themselves. This is the most important thing to bear in mind when you are evaluating .NET stuff to use at all or learn, okay? Seriously. Microsoft Orleans is also one of the best bits of .NET, okay? You don't have to do microservices anymore. You can just do a distributed application with single deployable units. It's amazing. Microsoft use it all over the shop, okay? So Orleans, it's good enough for Microsoft. It's good enough for you. But does Xbox use Blazor? Well, they've got a nice website here, xbox.com. Do they use Blazor? Yeah? Microsoft's .NET flagship web UI framework? Well, if you check out the developer tools, the answer may surprise you. Head to the docs, bring it over here, scroll up a bit, and no, they use React. Of course they use React. A normal person uses React for a web framework, and the Xbox team is no different, all right? Microsoft Teams also, would you believe it? The entire app is written in React, okay? React, now not Blazor, React. why not use Blazor? I don't know, that'd be nice, wouldn't it? Now there's a bigger picture to Teams because it's part of the Microsoft 365 world and SharePoint Online and Office 365 and all of this stuff. And the integrations there are all in a framework called SPFX. If you want to make widgets and stuff for Microsoft 365, and Microsoft 365 makes loads of money, they care about it, you basically have to use React today. You used to do it with really nasty .NET controls and run them on on-prem SharePoint and all this stuff. But now it's all React. Can you do it in Blazor? No, there are user voice requests. Please add support to Blazor in SPFX web part. You can't even use Blazor for like a SharePoint component, right? Please add support to Blazor WASM. No, the default templates are all React. This poor sod has started trying to do it himself and has managed to get this here. But this, none of this would be necessary if the templates were available at Microsoft. And all the .NET team actually cared about the future of Blazor. And if they don't, you should not. Please don't waste your time. That is a message I'm trying to get across this video. Choose your technologies wisely. If you found that interesting, therapeutic at all, please leave a like. Helps the algo, all that stuff. And maybe watch another one of the videos, which might be over there. Cheers.